Hi, I'm Dr. Mukesh Gupta, obstetrician and gynecologist from Lenest Malad, Mumbai. Today we're going to discuss one of the commonest reasons for which a woman comes to the hospital, and that is white discharge, or what we call as leucorrhea, or the disease that is vaginitis. White discharge or vaginitis. Well, today we're going to discuss the top 10 things that you need to know about this particular problem. One of the commonest issue that a woman has, it almost 4 out of 5 women who come to the OPD have sometime or the other experienced the symptom of white discharge or vaginitis. So today we're going to discuss the top 5 things. Number 1, is it normal or not? Number 2, when do we meet the doctor? And when should we take actually the medical help? Number 3, the most important thing is what kind of medications or treatments that needs to be done. Number 4, is there something that we can do about the hygiene which will bring down our chances to land up with this problem? And last but not the least, what are the non-medical management issues or the other issues which can be taken care of besides the medicine which can help us to actually avoid the situation? That is, whether there is a natural method or whether it is on nutrition or other things. So we're going to discuss these 5 important things today. So let's start with the first thing, whether the white discharge is normal. Well, many times during the course of the menstrual cycle or during the whole month, a woman may have excessive white discharge, which can be just before the menses or at the time of ovulation, or even when you're in an arousal state of mind. All these factors can actually lead to excessive white discharge. Remember, our body has got glands, mucus glands, which are there, mucous membrane has got glands, which actually produces a little bit of fluid. That is normal. It is not necessary for you to be bothered and worried about. Sometimes a patient would just come in and say, "Doctor, I have a lot of white discharge," and we check it, there's no infection, there's no problem, it's just a normal white mucoid discharge coming from a healthy epithelium. So that's the first message. Second point is, then when do we decide that it is abnormal and we need to meet the doctor? If the discharge is extremely large quantity and it is actually soiling your undergarments, or actually it's uncontrolled, if there's a lot of itching or scratchiness that you feel around in your private parts, if it is foul smelling other than the routine smell like fishy odor or something like that, if it is different in consistency, that is thick, instead of a normal watery mucoid discharge, it is thick like maybe a cottage cheese or a clot, a white clot, something like that. Or if it is frothy, then it is an issue. The color, if it is not watery or whitish, but it is greenish or yellowish or something like that, or blood tinged, pinkish, brownish, then we need to inform the doctor. If there are a lot of rashes around the private parts, or ulcers or boils, then we need to report. So these are the basic reasons for which you need to actually go to the doctor and meet them urgently. If you have a lot of pelvic pain or backache associated with discharge, there might be a sign that you are having a PID or pelvic inflammatory disease, and that's when you definitely need to meet a doctor. Well, so this was the second important tip, when you need to meet the doctor. The third thing that we want to talk about is, how do we manage these infections? We need to first figure out why this infection has happened. So as a doctor, when a patient comes to us, first thing we try to ascertain whether it is normal or abnormal. And if it is abnormal, then what is the cause? Is it because of some allergy or rash, because of the detergent that you're using, or a fabric softener that you're using, or a perfume that you're using, or some cream or jelly or something like that, which is causing all this? That is what we want to first rule out. And then we want to look at the cause of infection. It can be one of the 3 commonest causes that we come across is bacterial vaginosis, candidiasis or the fungal infection, or the trichomoniasis. So as a doctor, we try to figure out what is the cause and then treat as per the cause. Many times it is not a very long therapy. You may require some oral medications. You may require some pessaries which are inserted in the vagina. You may require some ointment or cream to be applied in the private part. You may have to take treatment along with your partner, because sometimes it is transmitted from one partner to another. So all these small things are decided by the doctor, and your doctor will be able to tell you what exactly is needed for your type of white discharge. So this was the third tip that we need to know about. Fourth important thing that we need to know about vaginitis is hygiene issues. Well, many times the infection is actually not just because of the infection, but because of our poor hygiene issues. Now, doctor, I am very careful. I take absolute utmost care about myself. And still I'll end up with infection. I clean myself thoroughly. Every day I wash myself thoroughly. Well, that thoroughly may be a problem. If you use douche or if you use some, say for example, a jet spray or something, a shower, which you try to push inside and clean it thoroughly, actually you're dislodging the healthy microbiota inside the vagina. Now, our body has got a defense mechanism inside. If that pH changes because of the infection, or if the healthy microbiology is disturbed, then your chances of infection actually increases. So overzealous cleaning and douching in itself can actually lead to more vaginal discharge or white discharge. Besides this, we have a tendency when we are having cleaning ourselves, sometimes many of the Indian population who are bottom washers instead of bottom wipers, they clean from behind forwards, and the microorganism which is coming from the gastrointestinal tract actually is pulled up and it is actually introduced to the vagina or the urethral opening and leading to urinary tract infection, UTI. We'll be having a video separately made on that. Well, UTI is another big problem which can be caused because of this E. coli infection coming from actually the colon or the vaginitis. It's something that we need to be actually smart about. Second important thing that we need to understand is that the private parts, when you're cleaning them, you need to dry them up. If you leave moisture around, it is the biggest cause of infection. So that's the second important tip about hygiene. And the third important tip of hygiene is the kind of undergarment you wear. The undergarment test. What you need to do about the undergarment. Well, if your undergarment is staining and if it is soiled, the elastics on the side, okay, the edges on the side may carry a lot of microorganisms. If you wear wet or moist undergarment, especially in the rainy season or something like that, then itself, it can lead to a problem. So if you don't get a chance to dry them well in your dryer, you may use iron boards, and you can use iron to help you to dry them and also to reduce the risk of infection by increased temperature. Sunlight is a good idea for your undergarments, but it may not be possible in many of the household to manage that. So you can use these tricks. Another important thing about undergarment is remember satin, nylon, and all these things look very good on only glossy magazines and not on your skin. For skin, you need cotton, all right? So many times when you use these garments, where like your cycling shorts or your gym spandex or something like that, or you know, all these things may not help you breathe in your private parts, and that in itself can lead to higher chances of infection. So this is the fourth important tip about what you can do about the hygiene. Now last is, what other things can you do from lifestyle perspective, which will reduce your chance from getting this infection again and again? So if you look at it broadly, I can say number one is your diet. Cut down on those sugars. Yes, diabetes in itself or high sugar in the circulation is also a bad idea for landing up with infection repeatedly. In fact, even your partner, if the partner is diabetic, a very high chance of repeatedly getting that white discharge and white infection, leucorrhea. Second thing that we need to understand is about improving your immunity. So, well, when we talk about diet, there's one more important thing. So all these pre-probiotics actually help actually to reduce the infection. Even a good amount of yogurt or dahi or curd in your diet is actually going to help you for reducing your risk of infection. Next is your sleep pattern. Stress, sleep, and immunity. These are important things. If your immunity is good, if you're not very stressed up, and if you're sleeping well, automatically also leads to better immunity, your chances of infection is lesser. And healthy lifestyle is definitely going to help you in these kind of situations. Last but not the least, monogamy. Remember, multiple partners, or if your partner has multiple partners, is one of the biggest risk factor for repeated and recurrent vaginal infection, which you don't want. So hence, these are the basic five top tips that you need to know. Get your pap smear regularly done. Also, your examination of vagina can help us know a lot more infections and other issues which can be there. Thank you very much.